Hey there, back in Sydney this week and just wanted to share a couple of insights and frustrations, if you like, around how we use KPIs. It just never seems to surprise me that so many leaders and managers tend to feel that the way we use KPIs is that we set them in a way that we know that we can achieve them. And then the whole game is then to pursue these KPIs and achieve them and get the numbers. Whereas that's not really what the game's all about. We have to be, and what we should be accountable for as managers and leaders, is knowing what performance is doing, knowing why it's doing that, and then we can deliberately set performance improvement and really seek those performance improvement goals that we're trying to go for. One of the things I think that helps us achieve that is we use in the pump approach to performance measurement a tool called an XmR chart, and these are statistical process control charts. They were invented by Walter Schuhart decades ago, used by W. Edwards Deming in the total quality management, Toyota production management system, Six Sigma, all those sort of things. And we use them in the pump methodology as well. And when we use XmR charts, we can actually see what performance is doing. We track the performance measure in a way that we can see what it's doing. We can pick up on the signals of where there's being any change. And the other thing that XmR charts allow us to do is to really set meaningful performance expectations. These performance expectations are about targets of whether we're trying to improve performance, whether it's an increase or decrease of what the average performance of the measure value is, and even potentially about reducing natural variation that's occurring within the measure. But the whole thing is for leaders and managers to say, let's really try and understand what performance is doing. And to do that, we have to use better tools. We have to use a tool like the XmR chart that gets us away from setting these targets and just going for these numbers and getting them any way that we can. What we have to do is understand what performance is doing and then really understand why it's doing that and set these meaningful targets that are based on trying to achieve that performance improvement. Anyway, if you'd like to know more about XmR charts, let me know. I've got a white paper that talks a little bit about XmR charts and how we can use them in dashboards as well. I hope this has been of value and thanks for watching.